This should go
2, 1,
start.
Armed, 0, 0, 0,
I hit
0,
start.
0,
4,
0,
5,
41.0, 0, 0,
I start. I'm
0,
off. I'm totally
0,
off, I did not get
0,
that started.
0,
it's alright, we got 0. Double. Just don't even. Is this going?
No, you're gonna have to start it.
This one?
No, this one.
Okay.
This is going in a second, at 10 second mark. So I just need you to really hit that start now button, Brian.
Okay. This should go 17.
Armed. 2. 1.
Start.
Armed. 0, 0, 0,
I hit
0,
start.
0, 0.
Our main tracker glitched and started on its own 13 seconds early. It's supposed to start with the atomic clock that the whole track is timed with. We're still not sure what happened.
41.5, 0, 0, 0, 0.
I'm trying to help Brian get some settings taken care of so he can drive and pay attention to the road. We're way below our target speed. I'm frazzled, trying to watch everything, trying to look at the course map. He's trying to drive. It's just turned into a disaster at this point.
Thank you.
this point, we finally started to calm down, started to dial the time in, and things were starting to make sense and click. Thankfully.
Thank you.
bugs were really bad this year. You're starting to see them here get built up on the windshield. Since we're timing manually, I'm trying to do math at about 160 miles an hour, so when Brian calls out the mile markers, I start doing math. By the time I finish the math, we've passed the next mile marker, and my time's all off. So it's a little bit nerve-wracking, but we're starting to get our pace down. recovery. Yep. Left level 4. To a right level 3. And into a right level 5. Lady apex. Right level 3. Couple of times during the race, Brian called out that the Mustang that started behind us was gaining. Right about here, he hollered out, "He's coming up on us fast." If you're running your race right, and the guy behind you is running his race, you should never see each other. So it was pretty alarming with all the problems we had. Both of us kind of panicked again, and we're thinking that we're timing was just way, way off.
Thank you.
pause right here and explain a couple of things. The timer in the bottom right-hand corner is in seconds. Our goal is 36 minutes on the dot, which is 2,160 seconds. You can see the clock there, 2,159.96 seconds. You couldn't get much closer than that. But the time starts when the official clock hits zero and they flag you, not when you move. We had to have been close, Brian.
Man, my cheek is killing me.
I'm sorry, buddy. We were right there. Right there.
I hope so.
It was right there.
That was a brutal race.
B, that was right there. Right at that last 15, 20 seconds when we were up and down, we were right there. And him passing us, he was way fast.
Right.
Way fast. He has no idea what he's doing. Or I'm a total idiot.
Right. I've been hot this whole race. Oh, I'm sorry.
No, you're good. You're good. Both clocks right there. I mean, right there.
You want the radio? Do you want the radio?
You want some finisher packs?
Sure.
I figured you did. We'll make a trade.
Thank you, ma'am.
How was your run?
Interesting. That's the best I can say right now.
Okay.
Yeah, interesting, but telling you, I'd be highly, highly interested.
Yeah.
Just to see, because I'm telling you, it was him.
Yeah.
Right there. Wow, look at all the bugs. Glad we weren't driving into the sun that whole time. Now that all the chaos was over, it was time to head south, stop in at a little local diner, and get some breakfast.
Time for some food.
Full bellies, time to head back to Ely, go to the hotel, clean up, and get some rest before the banquet.
Coursework team, whatever you're doing to support the event, thank you very much. So, okay, in the 150 class, in fourth place, oh wait, they don't give me a trophy for fourth place.
Oh.
In third place, and with a time variance of 0.2582 seconds off perfect, in a 2023 Chevy Z06, David Foote and Rick Gray. Yeah. Okay, well, moving right along. In second place, with a time variance of 0.2345 seconds off perfect, and another Chevy Corvette, Frank Roach, the third Frank Roach Sr.
Nice, nice.
I want to thank Frank and Neil both. They were both rookie assistants with me this time, and it made things a lot easier. Thank you guys. And in first place, with another great time, I think it's the second time I've had to say something like this tonight, 0.0013 seconds off. Yeah, 0.0013. No surprise though, most of us know this, 1999 Pontiac Trans Am, Andy and Susie Kowalczyk.
Very good. Road gets smoother, here's why.
Welcome to Texas.
Thank goodness, there's no place like home. Things are so cool when you get up here. Look how thick the paint is. It is nuts. Yeah, thick. It's almost like rubber. It's cool. I was like working in a paint shop. I'll grab you a souvenir while you're here. Stop playing, you're gonna hurt yourself. You're not a kid anymore.
It's beautiful artwork.
Yes, he does.
Fun's over. Time to get home. Gotta get back to work.
That's why I was sitting there.
Before we close this one out, wanted to say a special thanks to the town of Ely, Nevada, and to Peter and his crew at Motel 6. It really made us feel welcome. And they claimed that we were the official drivers of Motel 6. So all I can say is we'll leave the light on for you. Send that sponsorship check when you're ready.